The chart of accounts is a list of all your company's accounts and balances. QuickBooks uses this list to organize your transactions on your reports and tax forms. Your chart of accounts also organizes your transactions so you know how much money you have and owe in each account. Much like your financial statements, your chart of accounts is divided up into different sections. Let's take a look at the chart of accounts by clicking on Accounting and Chart of Accounts. The order of accounts that appear on the chart of accounts is determined by the account type. The account type also determines which financial statement it appears on and how you use it on transactions. The chart of accounts displays the type of each account here in the Type column. In the first section of the chart of accounts, you see asset accounts, just as they appear on the balance sheet. Scrolling down, there are also liability accounts and equity accounts. These accounts are organized in the same order as the balance sheet. Scrolling down further, we also see income, cost of goods sold, and expense accounts. These accounts appear in the exact same order as the profit and loss statement. When you create a new account, scroll to the top of the chart of accounts and click New. The very first thing QuickBooks asks you to enter is the category type. Category type determines if the account appears on the balance sheet or profit and loss statement. At the top are the balance sheet accounts, followed by the profit and loss statement accounts. To set up a new account, all you have to do is set up the type of account you want to create and then choose a detail type. The detail type does not determine how the account is used or how it's displayed on a financial statement. It's merely more information that you enter into QuickBooks as a kind of description. In this example, we added a checking account. By connecting to your bank, QuickBooks automatically creates the correct checking account in your chart of accounts. Then enter a name for the account you are creating up here at the top right. QuickBooks also gives you a separate description field, and you can make an account a sub-account of another account. Finally, if you're entering an account that appears on the balance sheet, you can also enter the opening balance here, and the as-of date for when you had that balance. This is most common for new bank and credit card accounts. Enter the starting balance of the account before you add transactions to QuickBooks. Leave the field empty if you are not sure what to enter. You or your accountant can change it later. Once you're done entering your account's information, click Save and Close. Now the new account appears on the chart of accounts and you can use it just like any other account. Remember to set up an account for anything that is important to you to see to make good decisions or to track for tax purposes. Now you know how to set up your own chart of accounts.